Hello and welcome everyone. It is time for Jim Comics Top Picks for New Comic Book Day this upcoming Wednesday, October 30th, 2024. Got another good week of books coming. A little lighter week for me this week, but there's still some books I'm definitely picking up this week. Man, there are some good ones. But hey, it's all good. I don't mind a lighter week once in a while. Hope you're all doing well. I want to say you're all awesome. We're all here because we love comics, so we'll get into what I'm looking at this week, some of my picks, and some other stuff. But I want to start out, I'm going to start with Wolverine. I talked about Wolverine in one of my videos a couple weeks ago about paying attention to these, because I really think something's coming in these next few issues. Well, two and three especially, he's got an all-new villain. Because this Wolverine number two, this came out 50 years to the month that 180 came out. And then issue 3 comes out 50 years to the month that 181 came out, which you all know are big books. So in issue 2, I don't know if you all read this or not, but basically it's Wolverine fighting the new Wendigo and everything else in the forest. But he gets to a spot where the Wendigo doesn't want to fight him, and he kind of gets him to follow him out to this cabin out in the woods, and he hands him this journal. I hope I'm getting this in frame here. I got a peek. And inside the journal, there's this two-page spread. I showed this on my Instagram, but I think it's pretty important. So it's called Leonard's Freedom Journal, and it's amazingly, he's a really good artist. He draws it like a comic book, but anyways, there's Leonard and I think it was Ryan. Am I remembering the names right here? Yeah, Ryan. So these two guys, basically they escape from, looks like a juvie hall or whatever, and they run off to the woods, and, you know, they get really bad storm and everything, and Ryan passes out, and looks like Leonard takes a bite out of him because he's hungry. And I'm assuming technically this is your first appearance of these characters, and I'm assuming that Leonard becomes the Wendigo and then Ryan, or potentially the other way around, but either the one of these two becomes Wendigo, and the other one I'm assuming is going to transform into the new villain that shows up in issue 3. So I hope you got that, because, well, I mean, I don't know how important that is, but I, as a comic collector, you know me, I love to have my first appearances and stuff, and I think that's they don't throw a two-page spread like that for no reason into a comic book, especially in issue number two, which leads right into a new villain. So, anyways, I hope you got that, because that, and I hope you read that. It was a pretty good story, actually. I didn't mind that one. gonna get into what I'm looking at this week. I'll talk about Batman, and Absolute Batman in a bit, but anyways. Well, talking about it right now, because Absolute Batman number one, we got second print out this week, and I know I gotta right off the bat, I gotta say this Absolute Batman, some people love it, which includes me. I think it's awesome, because for me it's a whole new take on Batman, the Batman story. All, I mean, I know some of the, they're newer, they're the same characters, but a new version of the characters, plus there's obviously new ones in there. It's really good. I'm loving it so far. I mean, it's only one issue, but I'm loving it. This week is the second print comes out, so you got the main, what I'm calling cover A, the blue cover, which we've seen quite a while. I got that one on order. I got the Diodato, I think that's a cardstock cover. That one I got on order too. I really like that one. That's a nice cover. There's a foil cover, there's an incentive cover. You'll see images of them on the screen. I just got the first two, the DeGrotta and the Diodato. But I want to say with this Batman, this reminds me, obviously the story's different, but it reminds me so much of the Venom run when it first launched years ago. And the unfortunate thing with comics is, you know, like, it's not going to last forever. At some point, Scott Snyder is going to, you know, get pulled off and go do something else, or want more money, or who knows what. And they're going to change writers and everything else. So all I can tell you is enjoy it while it's there, man. And this, if you haven't got this Absolute Batman on your pull list, I'm going to say the same thing I said about this. You shouldn't even be collecting comics. So get it on your pull list. That's all I got to say. And get all the, you know, like with Venom, there's, you know, all the extra printings and stuff. Get them all if you can afford it. I mean, whatever, but. I'm going to just say I highly, highly recommend that series. I mean, I know it's kind of a no-brainer at this point, but, man, just get it. You'll really appreciate it. 5-10 years from now, when you look back, you'll be glad you got all those books. DC All-In number one, second print is out this week as well. That's another no-brainer. There's a regular and a blank one for that. I'm just getting the regular cover. I got mine here somewhere. What did I do with those? I got them here. Hang on. I got my first prints. I should have put that out too. But I like this cover because it's a wraparound cover. I like the cover with the or the side with all the Absolute characters on there. Anyways, good stuff. That's all I got to say. We got a Penguin one shot out this week. I don't know if I'm going to get that one, but it looks kind of interesting. That's about it from DC, from Marvel. Captain America 14 cover B, a Dan Panosian cover. Man, is that a good cover. Doom cover. It's funny, you know, I saw the cover and I'm like, wow, that's a nice cover. And then I saw the who did the art. And I'm like, oh, Panosian, man. No wonder. I mean, his stuff was just so good. Boy, anyways, really good. another one for Marvel is Wolverine Revenge number 3. Whole bunch of covers for this. The regular cover, I kind of like the regular cover A, to be honest with you, Stegman's got, I'm going to show you Stegman's too. I love Stegman's art. He's got that one. I'm probably going to get the red band edition for this one, only because it's a 5-issue series. We're in issue 3, so if anything major is going to happen, if you know anything about writing, this is right about the point it will happen, so that's why I'm picking that one up. And I like the red band stuff, so anyways, there you go. Couple indies I'm looking at. Come Find Me number 1. That's a one shot from Distillery. Again, I like Distillery stuff, and this one looks interesting, but again, their prices, what kind of holds me back is their cover prices are kind of expensive. But anyways, got Hexiles number 1. Colin Bunn's the writer on this one, and I'm picking up cover A because I really like his stuff. I think he's pretty good, and that one's kind of a neat interesting story. And there's also Mud and Bat Madness number 1. It's looks like it's a World War I story. There's a bunch of covers for that. Cover A is the only one I'm getting on there. There are some nice covers in there, though. Looks like there's 4 different covers. So my picks this week is Absolute Batman number 1. Again, this is a no-brainer. Second print. I'm getting the A. I know these are going to be a higher print run on these second prints, so it's not like they're going to be worth $1 million tomorrow, but... Man, as part of your collection, this is just one of those runs you just want to get it. For me, it's A, and then also the Diodato, like I mentioned earlier. Those two are, I'm getting both. DC All In number 1, second print. Just the regular cover in black. It's kind of gone black and doesn't have as much color. Captain America number 14, that Panosian cover. That looks really good. I love his art. Man, his art is so good. And honorable mention is Wolverine Revenge number 3, the Red Band Edition. That's one I am getting as well. A couple other things I want to talk about. Looks like Kylo Ren, there's a new series coming out in February of next year. Kylo Ren is not my favorite character, to be honest. I do like the Star Wars stuff. But it's kind of been, it hasn't been the top of my list lately, but this series looks pretty good. The cover A, it's a really nice cover. I can't remember I think it's Chu did that cover. Maybe not. Maybe Chu did cover B. Anyways, I like cover A. It's a really nice cover. Reminds me of the Clayton Crane did all the original Kylo Ren ones back when they're that 4-issue run that he did. Oh, that was a good run. I know this, you probably know this by now too, but Star Wars Jedi Knights, a new series, was announced at the New York Comic Con, coming out March 2025. Follows the whole Jedi Order kind of at its peak, so that, I don't know, that looks pretty, I think I'm going to get that one. That one looks pretty decent, so, because that's going to have some decent stories in it, I hope, anyway, so. Anyways, that's all I got for you, folks. It's kind of a lighter week this week and not a ton to talk about stuff coming out this week. So, but there are some good books. And like I say, this Absolute Batman, just get it on your pulls. If you don't, and buy multiple copies. I usually get at least 2 cover A's. And then if they're nice variants, I'll get some of those. Or I'll even get 3 or 4 cover A's. Because at some point, there are going to be new characters coming. Not just different versions of, you know, like the Joker and Penguin and Riddler and all that, but man, just get it. That's all I can say. Anyways, take care, everyone. Talk to you later. Bye for now.